just a part.
No. No. If you want misguidance, listen to Yasir Qadhi. If you want to be misguided, listen to Yasir Qadhi. Yasir Qadhi has an agenda for Muslims in America, unfortunately. وَمَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ فِتْنَتَهُ فَلَنْ تَمْلِكَ لَهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا. If you want to be misguided, listen to Yasir Qadhi.
Refuting Yasir al-Qadhi. I accuse you after I have mentioned all of those ayat which makes invoking worship. And the Prophet said, supplication is worship, invoking is worship, and you are denying this. What's the matter with you?
Everything that he's saying here and doing, he's just priming the audience to accept this kind of reformist mentality.
But there's no people of knowledge today like Yasir Qadhi who, you know, will come up with these new discoveries. Oh, it's not shirk for you to call on someone besides Allah unless you believe that he is Allah. Yani, you must be as intelligent as a doorbell to even make the statement.
I would advise Dr. Yasir Qadhi to stop indulging in this because this is not his field. He's not an authority to say.
Dr. Yasir Qadhi is trying to deal with his past. He is bottling up feelings of resentment against the Athari school. He is angry. He feels betrayed. He feels hurt. He feels pain. This is not my psychological analysis of him. This is what he says of himself.
The second opinion, which is now the opinion that I follow, is the opinion that invoking the saints, it is haram, and it is evil, and it is an evil innovation, a religious innovation, a bid'ah, and it is a stepping stone to shirk. It is opening the doors to shirk, but it is not shirk in and of itself, unless that action is accompanied by a belief that you're calling out to a God. It is accompanied by a belief that you are deifying that entity that you are calling.
So invoking is considered to be shirk on the Day of Judgment. And this is what the Prophet said, الدعاء هو العبادة. Invoking, making dua is worship. Not a form of worship, no, is worship. This is the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Do not take knowledge from the likes of me or the likes of him. Take knowledge from real scholars. This quote-unquote renowned scholar, he's a da'i. He does not qualify to be a scholar. He's a student of knowledge.
But there's no people of knowledge today like Yasir Qadhi who, you know, will come up with these new discoveries. Oh, it's not shirk for you to call on someone besides Allah unless you believe that he is Allah. Yani, you must be as intelligent as a doorbell to even make the statement. Because you're technically claiming that no one has committed shirk ever, basically. And not even the Qurayshis. If you were to ask the people of Quraysh, do you believe that Allat wal Uzza were Allah? They would tell you, no, astaghfirullah. Wala in sa'altahum man khalaqa as-samawati wal ard layaqulunna Allah. The kuffar of Quraysh, if you were to ask them who created the heavens and the earth, they would say Allah. They did not believe that they were objects of worship. This feeble-minded creature now, with his research, comes and tells you, I've been studying so much. I am the PhD carrier from Yale University. He made the discovery that, mashallah, tabarakallah, Muhammad ibn Wahhab was a takfiri, and that, you know, he didn't know what he was doing. Yasir Qadhi, figure it out. This Yasir Qadhi should be shut down. His channel should be shut down. He should never be allowed to open his mouth about Islam. Wallahi, this person is a disaster that has engulfed this ummah. I wish and pray that Allah Azza wa Jal will guide him. Allah guide him, Ya Rabbi guide him. And if Allah doesn't have it in his decree to guide him, to remove him permanently so that we don't have to hear him rant about any Islamic subject matter. From the accused Prophet ﷺ of having ill intentions with Zainab bin Jahash, to claiming that Imam al-Barbahari didn't write this book, to claiming that Abdul Wahab was takfiri, to going against the way of Salafiyya, to now claiming that shirk is not shirk. What is left for this guy? Quran has, the narrative of the Quran has holes in it. The standard narrative. What is left for this person? And I'm baffled by Muslims who still listen to this clown. Where is your intelligence? To where do you want to go with your religion? You want to meet Allah Azza wa Jal with this garbage that you're learning from this guy? Look, very soon, I'm telling you, if you continue to listen to him, very soon it's going to be all wishy-washy, Christian, Jew, everybody goes to heaven. There will be no more foundations of Islam. They're being destroyed in front of you one after the other. And we talk about it, we warn against it, and instead of you feeling jealous for the deen of Allah, you get your feelings that, oh brother, why are you speaking about it? Did you send him an email? Did you call him on the phone? Did you go meet him? Just be quiet already with that stuff, man. This guy is publicly destroying Islam and you want us to go send him messages and emails and say, brother, please, do you have 5 minutes to talk to us? Forget that. Did he consult anyone before he came out with this nonsense? No. He does it publicly. He needs to be put down in his place publicly. There's no shirk unless you believe that that object of worship is that thing you're calling on is, you think it's Allah. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. MashaAllah, tabarakallah.
If a Deobandi has studied, you know, 10, 15, 20 years in his institute or an Azhari or a Medina guy, and then they dare break away from the standard narrative, as you are aware, that comes with a lot of baggage and a lot of tension. It's very difficult to do that. And my argument is very straightforward. So what if a lot of people said something, it doesn't make it right?
So what if a lot of people say something, it doesn't make it right? This is completely contrary to the usul in Islam, where we go from the Quran and then the Sunnah and then ijma'. Ijma', meaning consensus, is a very important part. It's one of the usul, an asl of the deen, because what people have said, what ulama have said, what the righteous have said and done in our history is a proof, is evidence.
Look, you know, if you're in an environment where 99% of your teachers are on one position and you're not challenged to think about that position, you will absorb that position and move on. That's the way the world works. There's nothing wrong with that, right? But the fact that 99% of your teachers say something doesn't mean it is the correct truth. It's just that's that school and they are taught a certain philosophy and they're taught a certain, whether it's aqidah, whether it's fiqh, whether it is a position like Ismail and Ishaq. The fact that you have not heard contrary and all the mashayikh you study with have not heard contrary means nothing, because in the end of the day, every firqa and every trend is basically within a spectrum of opinion. Very few people are brave enough or foolish enough, depending on how you want to look at it, because it comes with cons when you break away, right? To go outside the box and think for themselves, like, okay.
Look, again, everything that he's saying here and doing, he's just priming the audience to accept this kind of reformist mentality. It doesn't matter. All of these opinions, all of these rulings that we find in the Islamic tradition, they were limited to a madhab, right? They were all limited. His criticism applies to the entire Islamic tradition, because all of these different schools of fiqh, all of the schools of aqidah, they were in a particular time, in a particular place, with a segment of scholars and ulama, and he's saying it doesn't even matter if they were the majority. Even if they were the majority, quantity doesn't matter. They are just the product of their environment, of their time and their place, and political factors. He is in one fell swoop just undermining the entire Islamic tradition.
And by the way, this is now a well-known open secret amongst many Muslim graduate students and academics around the world. And this is well known. Traditional understandings of Ahruf and Qira'at cannot answer some of these pressing questions that are now being poked by our people outside of, by our academics, not our, by their academics outside of the faith tradition. You see, in a Muslim environment, there's always some respect that we have for the Quran. We should. In a Muslim environment, we'll press a little bit and then we'll say, okay, khalas, sami'na wa ata'na. And that's great, alhamdulillah. When you go to academia, they don't have that red line. And they're going to just, you know, the famous story of the emperor with no clothes. They're going to just point out, no, that doesn't make any sense. Well, that's not true, and this and that. And they'll bring issues, which I'm not going to mention explicitly, that you know are true because they're in your own books. They're not inventing anything new. They'll bring you riwayat, and they'll bring you athar, and then you add to that very well-known issues of
I don't even want to be explicit. And then you bring on top of that makhtutat. And then. And it's very clear to you and to every single very advanced student and specialist that the standard narrative has holes in it. That's what I'm going to say. The standard narrative does not answer some very pressing questions. Okay? This is what I'm going
to
say.
I would advise Dr. Yasir Qadhi to stop indulging in this because this is not his field. He's not an authority to say. He needs to delegate the task to the Ahlul Quran, to the Qur'an, to the masters of the Quran, people who have done PhDs in the Qur'an and they have mastered the transmission of the Quran. He needs to delegate to them, right? Instead of taking it upon himself, you know, talking about the Qur'an and Ahruf and how they correlate and how they relate to each other. So it was very unwise, I would say, of Brother Muhammad Hijab and Dr. Qadhi to discuss this in such a brief way and move on. Okay, they should not, you know, leave people confused. They must make things clear.
Dr. Yasir Qadhi is trying to deal with his past. He is bottling up feelings of resentment against the Athari school. He is angry. He feels betrayed. He feels hurt. He feels pain. This is not my psychological analysis of him. This is what he says of himself. Dr. Yasir Qadhi himself also informed us that he was quite the confrontational person, and that might have possibly led to his feelings of alienation as he was passionately and assertively propagating his views. And as a result, a growing number of people perhaps distanced themselves from him. And that kind of prodded him to investigate his beliefs and moved on to something else. But he didn't move on to another theological school like Ash'ariism or Maturidism. He's kind of without a theological madhab now.
Refuting Yasir al-Qadhi, I accuse you after I have mentioned all of those ayat which makes invoking worship. And the Prophet said, supplication is worship, invoking is worship, and you are denying this. What's the matter with you?
You have been to Medina studying in the university. You've been explaining the book of Tawheed, the four bases of Tawheed. So we can't say, oh, we leave him to his ignorance. You are a person of knowledge, but you're following your desire, and you are forming fatwas that fit the surrounding situation around you, such as Breilwi's Diobandis. You are giving them facilities on the account of Tawheed. You're not an ignorant person, but you're ignoring. There's a difference between ignorance and ignoring.
Why you keep persisting on this point? As if you are, well, in fact, you are opposing what Allah said. Allah is tens upon tens of verses. He made it clear that supplication, invoking, is worship. So if those people who invoke Jilani do not know that their supplication is worship, don't let it be your evidence. Don't let their ignorance be your evidence. I repeat, don't let their ignorance be your evidence. Okay? Number one. Number two. He says also that those people, they said that those saints are gods. While those who invoke Jilani, they don't say that he is God. Well, don't you remember what the Prophet said when people said to him, make for us a blessed tree, just like the tree that those pagans have? What did he say? He made their statement equal to those who said to Musa, make for us gods. So the Prophet is refuting people like you. Okay, there are people who do not know, but don't let their ignorance be your criterion, your standard, your decision, your fatwa. Otherwise, you are worse than the layman people.
If people are ignorant, we leave their matter to Allah. I mean, this is the least thing you can say. But if people do not know the Quranic ruling, it doesn't mean for their sake we change the ruling of Allah of this matter from being shirk to become bid'ah. The companions did not say to the Prophet, make for us gods. They said, let's have a tree, just like those pagans who have a blessed tree and they hang their swords on it. So why the Prophet ﷺ constituted them, saying to them that your statement is similar to the statement of the people of the Jews who said to Musa, make for us gods. Can you answer the Prophet? Please, for one time, please. Two questions. Can you answer what the Prophet said? Second question, is invoking worship or not? Please give an answer.
You have the knowledge, but you are hiding the fact that you know about that supplication is worship. Where can you run from this? How can you run from that when the Prophet said invoking is worship? Why do you want to run to the ignorance of people, ignoring what the Prophet said to you, that invoking is worship? How long are you going to keep ignoring this fact?
And by the way,
the friends that you pick pictures with them, such as Hatim Al-Auni, this man is an enemy of the Sunnah. This man is an enemy to some of the companions of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You're proudly taking pictures with them. You are, in a matter of fact, showing what happened to you and who are behind you, such as Hatim Auni and Hamza Yusuf and Nuh Keller. It seems you're responding to their pressures. So, as a result, you failed. You failed to defend your point. You can't, because the Prophet said it to you. Invoking is worship. How can you run away from this? You won't. So stop your persistence for evil and justifying the evil of those who invoke the dead. Invoking the dead is worship. And that's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that those whom you are worshipping, they are dead, He said after that, your God is only one God. Right after that, in Surah An-Nahl, verse 22. The chapter number is 16. So it's very obvious. When Allah the Almighty prohibited on those pagan people asking the dead, He said, your God is only one God. You don't understand, as I said it before, you do not understand the Islamic terminology, such as the word ilah. What does the meaning of ilah? Ilah is the one whom people run to for their asylum, for their fear, for their hardship, for their disasters. So when you ask the dead to remove these hardships from you, you're making them God. Why? Because you're giving them divine quality. You are deifying them by giving them a divine quality that they hear at any moment, any language. Do they watch Al Jazeera? Does Jilani watch Al Jazeera, by the way? Maybe. Why not? Because he watches everything. Anyone at any time, even if he's in the bathroom, he can respond to his call. If he says, oh, I suffer some stomach pains. Oh, Jilani, help me. Even in the bathroom. He knows, he hears at any time, at any place, by any language. He's ready. He gives. Just like this stupid Habashi. He said it. And I have it by voice. He said that if you ask Jilani for help, he will get out of his grave, give you your need, then he returns to his grave. Stop. Why didn't he pass by a mini market, buying some chips, things for refreshment, then he go back to his grave? What's wrong with you? You used to be a good person before, but it's Allah who guides whom He will and misguide whom He will. So stop justifying for the paganism and don't use the ignorance of people as an evidence for you. Ignorance is not evidence, but you're making it evidence because your agenda. Wassalamu alaikum.